Today is day of change.
Hoy es día de cambio.
People don't want the glory of God.
La gente no quiere la gloria de Dios.
People don't want the presence of God.
No quiere la presencia de Dios.
Because the presence of God is a type of change.
Porque la presencia de Dios es tipo de cambio.
Change.
Cambio.
This is a movement of change.
Esto es movimiento de cambio.
Stop being conformed.
Pero deje de conformarse.
And be transformed.
Y entonces transfórmese.
Change is on the way.
Viene el cambio.
Change
el
is on the way.
Cambio está en camino.
Sacúdete.
Shake it off.
Blessing to you, I'm Apostle Guillermo Maldonado, and I'm ready to release something powerful to you. How to be transformed into the presence of God. Remember what the Bible says, that we are going from glory to glory, from faith to faith. That means as a movement, the glory was never designed to be in one place. And this is the question I ask you, what glory did you camp? Did you camp in the old fashioned revival, or do you want a new glory in your life? So I want you to be ready, stay connected, and we'll be back in a minute.
We are so confident that God will speak to you in a supernatural way through Apostle Maldonado's powerful book, The Glory of God, that we will give you the first chapter of the book absolutely free. Download it today at kingjesusministry.org.
How can we bring transformation and change in our life? You know, when we go to the scriptures, 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 18, and read this way, we are going from glory to glory. I have seen many people, this is the pattern in church. I have seen that people stagnated for some reason. They conform to something. And this is what I can share with you. Whatever you conform, or when you conform to something, is because you stop being transformed. I have seen it in my own life. When nothing is happening, is because my life is conformed. And the second truth to that is this: whatever you conform to, it becomes your reality. So many people that are watching right now, you conform to sickness. You conform to poverty. You conform to be lonely. You conform to fear. You conform to doubt. And that's what the way you think. So every time somebody comes to you and tells you, you can be free. No, Pastor, it's too hard. I don't think so. It's too hard. Why? Because your reality, because your mindset, and this is the third truth to it, that your reality, whatever, when you stop being conformed, when you stop being transformed, it's because you stop being transformed. And whatever you conform to becomes your reality. And your reality is the way you think. In other words, if you conform into sickness, you think like sickness. If you conform to be without job, you conform to it, and that's the way you think. One time I asked the pastor, and I said, Pastor, you can take this church to be a mega church. And then he gave me seven reasons why he could not do that. Because that was his reality. That was the way he thought, his thinking. So what I'm trying to tell you is this. If you stop being transformed, it's because the supernatural lifted from you. If you stop being changed, that's what the Bible says, where if you go from glory to glory, if that transformation of the heart, change in you, stop in you, is because the supernatural, is because the presence lifted from you. So the next step to this is this one. The Bible says that the Christian life was never designed to be stagnant, was never designed to be in the same place. My question to you is this: are you tired to be in the same place? Are you tired to be without job? Are you tired to be with this kind of sickness? Are you tired to be afraid? Are you tired to be in the same place? Well, that tells you the presence lifted. And unfortunately, in America and in many countries, we have lived without the presence for so long that we don't miss the presence. And we come to church, have a nice time, have a coffee, you know, 25 minutes of preaching, but no presence, no power. And that tells you, if you don't be in change, when we come to church, we must come to be changed. Why? Because the presence should be there. The presence must be there. But now, because of the absence of the presence, we practice the absence of the presence in our midst. So the Bible talks about the being changed from glory to glory. So the Christian life was never designed to be stagnant, never designed to be in the same place. So my question to you is this: are you the same person 1 year after, a year ago? Are you the same person 2 years ago? Pastor, I had the same problem 2 years ago, and I got the same problem now. I got the same marriage problem, and now it's the same problem. I got the same sickness 2 years ago, and I got the same sickness now. That tells you something wrong. The presence is not working. The supernatural is not working in you. So the presence, how can you be transformed? How can I be transformed, Pastor? First of all, every transformation starts in your mind. Every transformation starts in your mind. Can you explain? Well, I can explain to you. You, if your reality now, you being conformed to an environment, that's what the Bible says. We don't walk by sight, but by faith. Well, walking by sight means we are conformed to that way of thinking, the environment, the atmosphere, what we're living in. So that's the reason your change will start with your mind. You must make a decision and change the way you think. Yes, it is possible to come out from your depression. It is possible to be healed. It is possible for you to be delivered. It is possible for you to be changed. Pastor, I tried to change. I went to the psychologist. I went to the psychiatrist. I went to my, and nothing is happening. Well, you're looking for replacements. Replacements will not do the job. It's the presence of God that will do the job. So it's the powers, the presence of God that will do the job in your life. So what I'm trying to tell you is, Pastor, I tried. I did many things to change. I am desperate. I'm using drugs. You don't understand my marriage. There's a lot of problems. Well, you're telling me things that I know. I deal with thousands of people every day, and I understand replacements of the presence and the power of God will not do it. Because the root of your problem is spiritual. And I can tell you, your change starts in your mind. So many people, change is a threat. When you talk about change, oh my God, no, change is too hard. I can't make it. I can't do it. Pastor, I don't think so. Well, you know, it's a threat. They're afraid of change because sometimes change is painful. But can I tell you something? After you go through that pain and the other side, you receive the reward of being transformed and becoming into the image and the likeness of Jesus Christ. So your change start where? In your mind. Number two, 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 18. The Bible says that we are being transformed. Trans means in transition, to be formed, to be transformed into what? And we are in transition to be formed like the image of Jesus Christ. We're being changed. We're being transition. We're going. So many of you are in transition. You're being in transition to becoming like Jesus Christ. Are you tired to be in the same place? Are you tired to be stagnated in your ministry? Are you tired to say, Pastor, I tried to do the best that I could? You know, sometimes pastors, with the best intention, We're trying to bring church growth with human methods. We're trying to bring change in our ministry, in our lives, with natural means. And you know, when the Bible says it is about the supernatural, it's about His presence, it's about the revelation of the Word, it's about the blood, it's about the anointing, the Bible, why are we going to look for replacements to bring change? So that transformation will take place in a moment of a supernatural encounter with the presence of God. Let me give you a testimony. I have met thousands of people in more than 50 countries of the world, and they told me this is the most common thing that they share with me. They say, Pastor, Apostle, when I have an encounter with the presence of God, the moment I had that encounter, my life changed forever. It was a before and after that encounter. So I seen the worst criminals. I've seen the worst gang members. I've seen lawyers. I've seen doctors. I've seen accountants. I've seen young, and I've seen adults, and I've seen women, and I've seen men being changed in 1 second, in one moment, in the presence of God. Their lives will totally, totally, drastically change because of the presence of God. The presence of God can go into your spirit, into your heart, and something that you've been struggling for so long, in one encounter, one moment, one encounter will change your life. This is what I share in my book, in one of the chapters of the book of the glory, about the encounter, about the presence of God, and how to be transformed. And I can tell you, I have seen thousands of people that in one moment, in one time, you know, I've seen witches, I've seen garlocks, I've seen many people being transformed and being changed one moment in the presence. So the transformation starts in your mind. Number two, the transformation starts in your heart through a supernatural encounter with the presence of God. And can I tell you this? And this is the million-dollar question. Are you conformed to religion, or are you transformed by His glory? When Christianity stop being the design that God did it, the pattern. Let me put it this way. When your life stopped being transformed and changed, your Christianity became a religion. Religion, none of the religion of the world have the power to change anybody. None of the religion of the world have the power to transform people. Because the transformation of Christianity is based on the power of the resurrection. And because Jesus is alive, you can be changed. You can be transformed in this moment, right now. So the question is, could you want to be conformed to religion? Or you want to be stagnated? You'd be stagnated with religion without fruit. Nothing is happening in your life. You are the same yesterday, today, and forever. And nothing is changing. No miracles, no signs, no wonders, no souls, no transformation. You conform to this poverty and healing and diseases. Or will you want to be transformed by the presence of God? Can I pray for you, Father, in the name of Jesus? I pray for every person that is watching, for them to have a supernatural encounter with your presence, with your glory. And I believe right now, Lord, they make a decision and they renounce. If you're watching me right now, say it, I renounce to this environment and the way of thinking that I've been having for so long. Right now, Lord Jesus, I renounce. And Father, I release an appetite for your presence. For those people that are watching, for them to be touched and be transformed to go from glory to glory. I release your presence, Lord, upon homes and offices and every person that is watching, and they're hungry and thirsty and they tired of being the same thing. They tired to go to church and not to be touched and not to be transformed, but they're hungry. They thirsty for the presence of God. I release that presence. I release that power. Touch the people and touch the heart. And I rebuke every bondage on the heart of the people. Those people that are struggling with vices and bad habits and addictions and drugs and alcohol and many things in their life, I set you free in Jesus' name, and I declare a change right now. Right now, be changed, be transformed, be delivered, be saved in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. God bless you.
The Bible is full of evidence that God wants to supernaturally intervene in our lives. Listen to these powerful testimonies of everyday men and women of all ages and races, and believe for your own miracle today at KingJesusMinistry.org.
When you come to CAP, you get empowered. God speaks to your faith and ministers to you, and you receive that presence of God so you can go and take it to your family, to your friends, and to school, and to everywhere you go.
Well, basically, the atmosphere, I mean, it's indescribable. I mean, just feeling the presence of God is something that when you come to CAP, you experience something different.
You want your breakthrough, you want your miracle, don't miss out.
Because the glory of God that's going to manifest all over the world, part of it has started right here.
Of Christianity.
La esencia del cristianismo
is being transformed.
Es ser transformado.
If you remove transformation of Christianity,
si usted quita la transformación del cristianismo,
you will have a religion.
Usted lo que le queda es una religión.
Ninguna religión del mundo tiene la habilidad de transformar el corazón.
No religion of the world has the ability to transform the heart.
Ninguna religión del mundo tiene la habilidad de transformar el corazón.
No religion of the world has the ability to transform the heart.
La esencia del cristianismo,
the essence of Christianity,
es la transformación del corazón.
It's the transformation of the heart.
Para eso Dios te trajo.
That's why God
para transformar tu corazón.
To transform your heart.
El equivalente de la transformación es cambio.
The equivalent of transformation is change.
¿Cuántos quieren cambio?
How many want changes?
Cuando no hay cambios en tu vida,
when there aren't changes in your life,
means the presence of God stop operating in you.
Eso significa la presencia de Dios dejó de operar en usted.
The supernatural stop operating in you.
Lo sobrenatural dejó de operar.
What is transformation?
¿Qué es transformación?
What is transformation?
¿Qué es transformación?
It's the essence of Christianity.
Es la esencia del cristianismo.
Why there's no transformation, there's no change in people.
¿Por qué no hay transformación, no hay cambio en la
muy
gente?
Muy simple.
Very simple.
La presencia de Dios se levantó.
The presence of God has lifted.
¿Cómo toma lugar el estancamiento y paramos de ser cambiados y transformados?
How does that stagnation take place so that we stop being transformed and changed?
Todo aquello a lo cual nos conformamos viene a ser nuestra realidad. Anote.
Everything we conform to becomes our reality.
Anótelo.
Write it down.
Todo aquello a lo cual nos conformamos viene a ser nuestra realidad.
Everything we conform to becomes our reality.
Cuando no somos transformados, perdemos relevancia.
When we are not transformed, we lose relevance.
Y dejamos de ser parte activo en el cuerpo.
And we stop being an active part of
the body.
Write
this down.
Anote.
Cuando el cristiano cesa su transformación, pierde su poder y regresa a la religión y al formalismo.
When Christians stop being transformed, they lose their power and they go back to formalism.
Yo quiero escuchar un amén de la iglesia.
I'd like to hear an amen of the church.
When Christianity stop being transformed,
cuando en el cristianismo para la transformación,
being changed,
y de ser cambiado.
You're going back to religion.
Regresa usted a la religión.
You're going back to the motions.
Regresa al movimiento.
Empieza a repetir lo que ya sabe del pasado.
You start repeating what you learned in your past.
Pierde lo espontáneo.
You lose the spontaneity.
Y vuelve, pierde la vida de Dios.
And you lose the life of God.
¿Puede escuchar un amén, por favor?
Can I hear an amen there, please?
Jesús se conformó a nuestra imagen para que nosotros fuésemos transformados.
Conform to our image that we may be transformed.
Anote esto.
Write this down.
El propósito de la vida cristiana es que lleguemos a ser a la imagen y semejanza de Cristo.
The purpose of Christian life is that we become like the image of Christ Jesus.
Write this down.
Anote.
La madurez espiritual de una persona,
spiritual maturity in a person,
se mide en razón del cambio,
is measured by their change.
Yo no creo que usted recibió lo que acabo de decir.
I don't know if you received what I just
said. La madurez de una persona,
maturity in a person,
se mide en razón del cambio,
is measured by their degree of change.
Si usted paró de cambiar,
if you stop changing,
y paró de ser transformado,
and you stop being transformed,
you have another religion.
Usted lo que tiene es otra religión.
God brought you here,
y Dios le trajo
aquí, to tell you Christianity is not a religion.
Para decirle que el cristianismo no es una religión.
Pero nosotros le hemos vuelto una religión.
But we've turned it into a religion.
Nosotros los cristianos.
We the Christians.
Estamos acá en la iglesia.
Are we here church?
So what is transformation?
¿Qué es transformación?
What is transformation?
¿Qué es transformación?
Write this down please.
Anótelo por favor.
The purpose of transformation.
El propósito de la transformación
is the changing of the heart.
Es el cambio del corazón.
El propósito de la transformación,
the purpose of transformation,
es el cambio de corazón,
is the changing of the heart.
Voy a decirlo otra vez.
I'll say that again.
The purpose of transformation,
el propósito de la transformación,
is the changing of the heart.
Es el cambio del corazón.
Jesús dijo en Mateo,
Jesus said in Matthew,
this is what he said,
esto dijo,
Matthew 15:19,
Mateo 15, 19,
porque del corazón salen los malos pensamientos,
from the heart comes
los
the
homicidios,
thoughts,
los adulterios,
adultery,
las fornicaciones, los hurtos,
thefts,
los falsos testimonios,
false witness,
las blasfemias,
blasphemies.
Cuando el corazón no está cambiado,
when the heart is not changed,
todo eso sale de adentro,
all of that comes out from within you.
So, ¿para qué venimos a una conferencia?
So why do we come to a conference?
Do we need just for dancing?
¿Venimos solo a danzar?
Or we need to be transformed?
¿O venimos a ser transformados?
We need to be changed.
Tenemos que ser cambiados.
You got two options, my friend.
¿Tiene usted, amigo, dos
you
opciones?
Conform to religion,
¿se conforma a la religión?
Or you being transformed by his presence.
¿O se transforma su presencia?
Tiene dos opciones.
You've got two options.
Dios te trajo para darte dos opciones.
God brought you to give you two options.
You conform to religion,
¿o se transforma la
or
religión?
Or you being transformed by the power of the God.
¿O se transforma por el poder de Dios?
Do you want the glory of God?
¿Quiere usted la gloria de Dios?
¿O quiere lo mismo de siempre?
Or do you want the same old thing?
¿Quiere lo mismo de siempre?
Do you want the same old thing?
¿O quieres ser cambiado?
Or do you want to be changed?
¿Quieres ser transformado?
Do you want to be transformed?
Escoge hoy.
You choose today.
Confórmate a una religión.
Conform to a religion.
A un cristianismo.
To a Christianity.
Sin poder.
Without power.
Sin cambio.
Without change.
Mecánico.
That's mechanic.
Sin la vida de Dios.
Without the life of God.
O eres cambiado.
Or you're changed.
Transformado.
Transformed.
Por la presencia de Dios.
In the presence of God.
Does anybody say amen?
Alguien diga amén.
Levanta tu mano al cielo.
Lift up your hands in heaven.
I want to be changed.
Quiero ser cambiado.
From glory.
De gloria.
To glory.
De gloria.
From glory.
De gloria.
To glory.
En gloria.
I said from glory.
Dije que de gloria.
To glory.
En gloria.
That's the main issue of Christianity.
Eso es lo principal en el cristianismo.
Si el mensaje que estás predicando,
if the message you're preaching,
no está cambiando el corazón de la gente,
it's not changing the hearts of people.
You're preaching religion.
Usted está predicando en religión.
El mensaje que estás predicando,
the message that you're preaching,
tiene que cambiar al drogadicto,
has to change the drug
tiene
addict,
que cambiar la prostituta,
it has to change the prostitute,
tiene que cambiar al hombre de negocio,
it has to change the businessman,
he has to be changing,
tiene que estar cambiando.
If you're not changing,
si usted no cambia,
you're stagnant,
usted está estancado,
you're not moving,
no se está moviendo,
you're there in the same place,
está en lo mismo,
you need the presence,
necesita
you
la presencia,
need the glory,
la gloria,
shout somebody,
grite alguien.
Muchos de ustedes
Many of you
están conformados
are conformed
a una a la enfermedad,
to sickness,
al dolor,
to the pain,
a la tristeza,
to sadness,
a la religión.
To religion.
No se mueven.
You don't move.
No hay cambio.
There's no change.
Estás conformado al pasado.
You're conformed to your
Pero
past.
Dios te trajo
But God brought you
para decirte
to say to you,
Today is day of change.
Hoy es día de cambio.
People don't want the glory of God.
La gente no quiere la gloria de Dios.
People don't want the presence of God.
No quiere la presencia
Because
de Dios.
The presence of God is a type of change.
Porque la presencia de Dios es tipo de cambio.
Change.
Cambio.
This is a movement of change.
Esto es movimiento de cambio.
Te vas, te quedas con tu religión o te montas conmigo.
You stay still with your religion or get on the train with me.
O sacudes tu ciudad.
Shake your city.
Sacudes tu familia.
You shake your family.
Stop. Being conformed.
Pero deje de conformarse.
And be transformed.
Y entonces transfórmese.
Change is on the way.
Viene el cambio
Change
en camino.
Is on the way.
Cambio está en
Sacúdete.
Camino. Shake it off.
You were not created to live in defeat. The Glory of God is a book you must have if you want to learn that God's presence is not just a theological concept. It is a reality that you can experience today. You will realize through this book that God's glory can radically change your life so that you can finally overcome the enemy that has been holding you back for years, no matter who you are or what circumstances you are facing. Order today your Glory of God resource package, which includes not only a copy of Apostle Maldonado's powerful book, The Glory of God, but also the anointed worship CD from The New Wine, the musical group of King Jesus Ministry. Call us at the number on your screen or visit our website now. We know these resources will be a great blessing to you, your friends, and family. You will be empowered to experience God in a tangible way, be activated to boldly pray for others, and see real healing and miracles happen. Don't wait to receive this revelation. Act now. Thank you for watching our program. We pray this message has blessed you. Remember that the glory of God is a reality. You need this revelation. Order these resources today by calling now at 305-382-3171 or visiting us online at kingjesusministry.org.
A Time for Change with Apostle Guillermo Maldonado is a program dedicated to transforming biblical principles and bringing back God's moral values to our society. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. If you have a prayer need or interested in obtaining a copy of today's program in audio or video, please write us at 14100 Southwest 144 Avenue, Miami, Florida, 33186. Call us at 305-382-3171 or visit our webpage, kingjesusministry.org. A Time for Change is produced by ERJ Media at King Jesus International Ministry. Thanks to the prayers and support of our friends in your area. Thank you for tuning in, and remember, today is a time for change.